Hello everybody, today we will talk about working length determination and there are many methods to determine a absolute working length. But today I will focus upon Engel's radiographic method. So let us start. Let us understand what is working length. Working length is a distance from coronal reference point to a point at which canal preparation and obturation should end. As we can see in this diagram, if our biomechanical preparation and obturation exceeds the working length out from the apex, it may create many post-operative complications like pain or RCT failure. So it is absolutely important to maintain the working length. Now let us understand what is coronal reference point. A coronal reference point is a stable anatomical landmark which never changes irrespective to how many times you measure the working length. The coronal reference point in respect to anterior teeth is incisal edge, and with respect to posterior it is cuspal tip. And in case if the anterior teeth is fractured, then we should grind the incisal edge so that we can have a stable landmark, and then we should proceed for a working length. Now let us examine the tooth morphologically. If you will examine a tooth anatomically, the apex is known as anatomical apex. The same apex, if you will examine it radiographically, it is known as radiographic apex. Anatomically, the apex has two parts. One is major diameter or apical foramen, which is situated eccentrically off-centered from the anatomical apex. The other part is minor diameter, or which is also known as apical constriction. The apical constriction is commonly 0.5 to 0.75 millimeters away from the anatomical apex, which is a major diameter. This is the reason we should never breach the anatomical constriction benchmark. This is the reason why our obturation and biomechanical preparation is always 0.5 millimeter shorter than the anatomical apex. Because if you will breach this landmark, it will cause post-operative complication. Because the gutta percha will irritate the PDL fibers, and which will cause post-operative pain. Let us now understand why Engel's radiographic technique is most reliable and functionally feasible in day-to-day practice. As per Grossman, when the Engel's radiographic technique is used in combination with the electronic apex locator, the findings are very much accurate and feasible. The instruments which are used in Engel's radiographic technique is basically K-file of size 6, 8 and 10. These sizes are very much fine enough to get inserted inside the root canal, and they are flexible enough to negotiate the curved canals. Precurving is an important phenomena in Engel's radiographic technique. By precurving files, we can easily manipulate file from curved canals. The principle behind Engel's radiographic technique is the preoperative knowledge of average length of every teeth. For example, here we will consider central incisor, whose average length is 23 millimeters. The first step in the radiographic Engel's technique is to take radiograph of a desired tooth which has to undergo root canal treatment. For example, we have taken radiograph of central incisor. The radiographic length is almost 23 millimeters, but as we know that the apical constriction is 0.5 to 1 millimeter away from the anatomical apex, we have to reduce the estimated working length by about 1 millimeter, which is approximately 22 millimeters. The second step is transferring this working length estimation into 10 number K file and adjusting stopper as per the new working length, that is 22 millimeters. The third step is to use Gates Glidden drill or end of flare burr to widen out and coronal flare the coronal part of canal so that the entire guide path can become straight and we can avoid any error with related to working length estimation. The fourth step is to again insert the K number file with a pre-adjusted working length into the canal and then repeat the radiograph, and then we have to check whether the apex of the K file is 0.5 to 1 millimeter short with reference to the radiographic apex. Step number 5 presents you with two scenarios. Scenario number 1, if the K file is exceeding 1 millimeter beyond the radiographic apex,
then you have to subtract 1 millimeter from the current working length, that is 22 minus 1 millimeter, which is 21 millimeters. Scenario number 2, if the apex of the K file is almost 1 millimeter short than the radiographic apex, then you have to add on at least 1 millimeter to the present working length, that is 22 plus 1, 23 millimeters. In this way, you can feasibly and easily and accurately estimate the working length of your tooth.